Hi guys, welcome back. In this section, we'll see about tolerances and dimensions. What are tolerances? What are dimensions? What are different types of tolerances? And what are different types of dimensions? As a revision to the previous section, we have seen about GDNT, geometric dimensioning and tolerances, different types of symbols, exactly 14 symbols will be there, right? And where do we use this GDNT and why do we use GDNT? GDNT is used for designing, manufacturing, quality, as well as inspection purpose. To maintain the exact manufacturing of the part or a component in a mechanical industry, right? So this is about GDNT, which we have seen in the last section. So now, tolerance. Tolerance is the buffer dimension. It can be a plus or a minus value. So as we know, none of the component is going to manufacture exactly by using a robot or a manual or a machine. We can't exactly manufacture a component. So for that, we need some buffer dimensions. It can be a plus dimension or a minus dimension. That buffer dimension is called as a tolerance zone, right? So it is represented as plus or minus symbol. Example, 40 plus or minus some value, or plus or minus 0.5, just an example. So this is called as a tolerance zone. So it can be 40 plus 0.5, 40 minus 0.5, 40.5, 39.5. So a component dimension can vary between this range. This range is called as a tolerance zone, right? So there are three types of tolerances: unilateral, bilateral, and compound. In most of the cases in manufacturing, we use only these two. This is of very rare cases. So this compound tolerance we use in a very rare situation. So first one, unilateral. As the name indicates, unilateral, that means only one tolerance, that means only one directional tolerance. It can be a plus or it can be a minus, but it cannot be both. As the name indicates, unilateral tolerance means that dimension can vary, or there can be a variation in that dimension with respect to positive or a negative axis. That is called as a unilateral tolerance. 40 plus 0.5, 40 minus 0.5, 40 plus 0 minus 0.2, 40 plus 0.2 minus 0. So these are some of the examples how we are going to represent a unilateral tolerance. So in the first case, that dimension, suppose you take a simple plate, right? Just to consider a simple plate. So in this, for example, we are taking 40. the length of the plate. So the tolerance will be 40 plus 0.5, means it can go up to 40.5. It can go 40 minus 39.5. So it can go up to 39.5, but it cannot go both. So where is this unilateral tolerance used? It is used in particular places based on applicational part. Based on the application of the part, we have to decide whether we have to give a unilateral tolerance or a bilateral tolerance. So in this similarly, 40 plus, this is also a unilateral tolerance because 0 indicates a zero plane. What do you call as a zero plane? Means it is an imaginary line. It is an imaginary line which divides a positive and a negative axis, or a positive coordinate and a negative coordinate. So this is called as a zero line or a zero plane, we call. So this zero has nothing to do in this situation. So it is considered as a unilateral tolerance because if you eliminate the zero, 40 minus 0.2, 39.8. In the second situation, 40.2. So this is one of the way of representation of unilateral tolerance. So these are the cases where we represent unilateral tolerances. Got it? So this is about the unilateral tolerance. Next one is bilateral. As the name indicates, bi means two, positive, negative. Say a particular dimension can vary in terms of positive coordinate or a positive line, or it can be a negative coordinate or a negative line. So dimension can increase or decrease. Let us take the same example. A plate of 40 mm and 50 mm. So here I am going to use 40 plus or minus 0.5. This 0.5 can vary, right? So in this case, 40 plus 0.5 and 40 minus 0.5, because we have not taken any zero in this. This is a representation of bilateral tolerance, one of the representation, right? So this dimension can vary 40.5 and 39.5 based on the mating component. Or based on the application, we have to decide whether we have to give a bilateral or unilateral tolerance. Right? So in this case, 40.5 and 39.5. So it can vary, increase or decrease. In the previous unilateral tolerance, we have given 40 plus 0.5 only. We have considered only one dimension, one tolerance, not one dimension, not one tolerance. Right? So this is one of the way of representation of bilateral tolerance. And another way is 40 plus 0.5 and minus 0.25. Or to simplify it, let us take a 0.1 for simple calculations. So what is the difference between this scenario and this scenario? Here the tolerance is 0.5 throughout. It can be plus 0.5 and minus 0.5. But in this case, the tolerance is increased, the dimension is increased to 0.5 and it is decreased to 0.1. Right? So in this situation, the upper tolerance limit, this is called as an upper limit. This is called as a lower limit. That means we are decreasing. That is why we call as a lower limit. We are in this case, we are increasing. This is called as a upper limit. So here upper limit will be, upper limit of the tolerance can go, of the dimension value can go up to 40.5, and the lower limit should be 39.9. It should not decrease below this 39.9. That is the condition. So how this condition is, we are going to decide based on the mating part or based on the application where this component is going to be assembled. So this is one of the way, this is one way, and this is other way of representing a bilateral tolerance, right? Coming to compound, it is a very rare situation, compound tolerance. So in this we are going to use linear dimension tolerances as well as angular dimensional tolerances. Angular tolerance in the sense, suppose consider this simple example. Right. Assume that this is a component. This is with respect to angle theta. Some x dimension. It can be tolerance of plus A and minus B. Y dimension, plus C and minus G, plus alpha minus beta. So this is called as a compound dimensioning, because this is called as an angular tolerance. For every dimension, whether it may be linear or angular, tolerance should be there. So for angular tolerances, we call as an angle. Suppose this is just an example. This is called as angular tolerance and this is called as linear tolerances. Right? So this is about the compound tolerances. So we have seen unilateral, bilateral and compound. In order to just take a simple example again, just I have taken, I have to explain it clearly. Or just taken a block. This is called as a zero plane. this is a block. This is a positive coordinate and this is a negative coordinate. This is called as a unilateral. This is called as a unilateral. Because this block has been placed on either on the positive nor on the negative side. Right? When it comes to here, this is called as a bilateral. Because the block has been placed in between on the zero plane. Some component, some part of the block has been on the positive coordinate and some block of the component on the negative component. And here, this block, it is falling on the zero plane. As I said, it is one of the representation. It has plus 0.5 and minus 0. Minus 0.5 plus 0. Something. Because it is falling on the zero plane. That is why we won't consider this thing. We call as a unilateral. Just it is a schematic representation to explain you, to understand it. Right? So this is about the tolerances. Unilateral, bilateral and compound tolerances. Right? In the next section, we will see about dimensions. Yeah, hope you understand well about these tolerances. Right? If you like this section, subscribe, share, comment. Thank you.